nowadays, the way we think about infectious disease is totally different. It used to be that we thought about sort of risk factors, you know, like what were these things that people did that made them more likely to catch an infectious disease? And they were factors about the person or the person's behavior or the person's environment. You know, pretty soon we're going to know why someone's susceptible to infectious disease because of their genotype. I mean, it's really going to be a different world.
Discoveries these days are made principally by teams of scientists who work at the intersection of scientific disciplines. And if you want to bring teams together, you have to speak at least two languages. You have to speak the language of your tribe, so to speak, and you have to speak the language of the other group you want to collaborate with. So what we want here is people who are bilingual in population health and in basic laboratory science. And that combination is really going to make them pretty much unique. And that's a huge value to their long-term future, to society and to science in general.
The University of Rochester Medical Center has a long history of very strong basic science and also quite strong population health science.
So we have the only respiratory pathogens research center in the country. We have one of only six SEER centers. These are centers of excellence in influenza research. We have one of only six national vaccine centers funded by the CDC.
We also have done studies for many, many years looking at the impact of vaccines at the population level. And this work has been done under the auspices of the Emerging Infections Program, which is a program that covers 10 sites in the U.S., and we are one of them.
And we have a Center for Community Health embedded in the center of Rochester itself. Those are all unique. They just don't exist at other places, at least not that collection of resources. What's also unique is we're going to have students have the opportunity to train with mentors both from population health and from basic science. So they get a twofer, two mentors, not the usual one. And part of the twofer they're going to get is the hands-on experience as well. So it's not just mentoring, it's hands-on learning in a laboratory setting. Either that's a wet laboratory or it's the community as a laboratory in terms of population health. But again, that's a key component of our program. So they don't just learn the language, they walk the walk, they talk the talk, they learn both disciplines.
In addition, it gives students an incredible spectrum of potential avenues to go down for their own research. So they'll be able to really choose things across the spectrum and really be able to decide whether they want to lean more towards basic science or more towards population health or work right in the middle.